Today, let's talk about the Calc 3 version of the second derivative test. And this right here is to help us find the local min, local max, or saddle points of a multivariable function. Let's talk about the steps first, and then later I'll show you guys an example. Here we go. Step 1, we are going to find the critical points. That's a point AB so that the partial derivative of f with respect to x and the partial derivative with respect to y, they are both equal to 0. Then we are going to compute the d value at AB, and that is just this formula. Of course, we have to use second derivative. And to remember this formula, you can just think about putting this into the determinant, fxx, fyy on this diagonal, and then we have fxy and fyx. But really, they are the same thing, right? The mixed partials are equal. But most likely our case are going to be next, so they are going to be equal. And then when you do this times this, it's just fxx, fyy, minus this times that. Because they are the same, we can put that as this thing squared. After that, we are going to pay attention to the d value. If the d value is greater than 0, then we have to do more work. Go ahead and compute the second derivative, fxx, at ab. If this second derivative is greater than 0, then we are going to get a local minimum at AB. So it's just like the Calc 1 version. You have a function that's concave up, so it's local min. And then, if the d value is greater than 0 and also fxx is less than 0, then we are going to get a local maximum. So this part is very similar to the Calc 1 stuff. Now though, if the d value is less than 0, then you are going to have a saddle point. Finally, if you get the d value is equal to 0, unfortunately, we cannot draw any conclusion. At AB, it could be a local min, it could be a local max, or maybe it could be a saddle point. We don't know. But anyways, let's go ahead and take a look at the example. So this is our example. First, let's just go ahead and do the partial derivative with respect to x first, and then we will have 4x to the third power. In the x world, y is a constant, so that will be 0. And then right here, I can just look at the derivative of x, which is just equal to 1, and then we maintain the constant multiple, so minus 4y. The derivative of 1 is 0, doesn't matter. And then we are going to set this to be 0. But in the meantime, we also need to get f sub y, and that will be 4y to the third power, and then minus 4x. And again, set this equal to 0 as well. Now, if you look at this equation, we can bring the 4y to the other side and then divide both sides by 4. So we get x cubed is equal to y. Similarly, do the same thing, and we will end up with y cubed is equal to x. Now, perhaps let's put y equals x to the third power, this thing right here, into this y. So we are going to get x cubed and then to the third power, and that is equal to x. So now, multiply the powers, we get 9, and put the x to the other side. So x to the 9 minus x is equal to 0. Factor on x. And then look at this as x to the fourth square. So we have a difference of 2 squares. So we get x times x to the 4th minus 1, x to the 4th plus 1. And then keep going. This right here is x, and then this right here is going to be x squared minus 1, x squared plus 1, and then x to the 4th plus 1, equal to 0. And then this right here, factor it, x minus 1, x plus 1, x to the 2nd plus 1, and then x to the 4th plus 1. That's equal to 0. Now have a look. For the first one, we know x is equal to 0. For the second one, we know x is equal to 1. For the third one, we know x is equal to negative 1. We will get imaginary number, imaginary solution. So we have 3 x values that we need. Now, when x is equal to 0, this right here tells us y will be 0 to the third power. So that's just equal to 0. When x is equal to 1, this right here tells us we have y is equal to 1. And then when x is equal to negative 1, again, just do the third power, so y it's also going to be negative 1. So 0, 0, 1, 1, negative 1, negative 1. These are our critical numbers, critical points. Now we are going to do the second derivative. So look at this. Let's go ahead and do fxx. That will give us 12x squared. That's it. And then let's also do fyy. So look at this, take the derivative with respect to y, 12y squared. Now we need fxy. So we have to look at fx and then differentiate this with respect to y. That will give us 0, and then take the derivative of this with respect to y, we will get negative 4. And in fact, this will be the same as fyx. Now let's look at the d. Right here is just going to be fxx times f y y, and then minus, let's put down f x y, just that, and then square. And let's work out a formula first. This right here is 12 x squared, and this right here is 12 y squared, and then minus this right here is negative 4, and then square. So we're looking at 144 x squared y squared minus 16. So that's a formula for d of x y. Now we are just going to be plugging these numbers into the d formula right here. So d of 0, 0, let's see. If I put 0 here and 0 here, of course that will be 0, so we just end up with negative 16. And guess what? That's less than 0, so you can just draw a conclusion right away. What is it? Remember, if d is less than 0, we get a saddle point at the origin 0, 0. So let's just write this down, saddle point. Okay, saddle point, yeah, 0, 0. Now, d of 1, 1. Let's do this in our head. D of 1, 1 is going to be 144 times 1 squared, 1 squared, so just that. And then minus 16, okay. 144 minus 16. Oh my goodness. It's 3 and then 14 is 8. Okay, and then that is 2. So it's 128. Alright, so d of 1, 1 is equal to positive 128. So that means we have to compute fxx at 1, 1. So fxx at 1, 1. Put 1 and 1 in here. Well, we get 12, which is greater than 0. Now, just think about the Calvin situation. When the second derivative is greater than 0, it's concave up, and then you get a local minimum. So I will just put down local min. Local minimum at 1, 1. Finally, d of negative 1, negative 1. If you put that in here, you will see it's also 128. But if you do fxy, negative 1, negative 1, well, okay, actually we still get positive 12. So we also have a local minimum at negative 1, negative 1. All right? Now let's do another example. This is our function, and here we go. First, do the partial with respect to x. We will have negative 3x squared plus 4y, and then the rest will be 0. And then, of course, set this to be 0. Next, fy, that will be 0. This right here will give us 4x. And then take the derivative of this, we get minus 4y. And that's it. And then set this to be 0. Now, if we take a look at the second equation, we can put this to the other side and then divide both sides by 4. So it implies y is equal to x. And then I can just put the x right here, substitute for the y. So we need to say negative 3x squared plus 4x is equal to 0, and then solve this. And I can factor out an x. And for the first one, we know x is equal to 0. And for the second one, we get x is equal to positive 4 over 3. Now, because x and y are the same, so we have two critical points. The first one is 0, 0, and the second one is 4 over 3, 4 over 3. Now, let's go ahead and do our second derivatives. Fxx, that will give us negative 6x. That's it. And then perhaps let's also do Fyy. That will give us negative 4. Then let's do Fxy, which is the same as Fyx. And that will just give us, let's look at the x equation and differentiate that with respect to y. We will just get 4. Okay, now let's go ahead and compute the d, which is, again, let's remember the formula. Fxx times Fyy minus Fxy and then squared. So, this times that, we get negative 6x times negative 4. And then minus 4. And then squared. So, that's 24x minus 16. Oh, it actually does not depend on y at all. Yeah. Let me double check. Yeah, it really doesn't depend on y. So now let's just go ahead and plug in this value. So firstly, if we have d at 0, 0, that's 0, and then we just get negative 16. So of course, that's less than 0. That's great, because we can conclude that we have a saddle point at 0, 0. Right? And then next, d at 4 over 3. So I will have to plug in 4 over 3 into here. So 24 times 4 over 3, that's 1, that's 8, that's going to be 32. 32 minus 16, we have positive 16 right here. Oh, okay. We have to do fxx. Add 4 over 3, 4 over 3. So plugging 4 over 3, 4 over 3 into here, we will get negative 6 times 4 over 3. Right? Reduce, this is 1, this is 2, so we get negative 8. So that's negative. So what do we say? We have a local maximum at 4 over 3, 4 over 3. Right? So that's it.